Well, my comment has to do with, well, let me first of all commend those who presented. I think it's a good job done. But what I see is you have brilliant models. How workable are they? I've not read your papers, but then, okay, but then nobody really talked about the infrastructure required into detail. The question is, do we have them? Can we really implement these models? Okay, I think that's something we need to look at.
I know that I think one or two of them have started talking to the utility companies. Is it electricity? Like so would you like to comment on that and the next group will come?
Yeah. Is it warehouse? So get you.
Hello. Yeah. For ECG, what we are trying to do is that we are not changing the meters that are in the system. So with my embedded system, we are trying to interface with the current meters that we have. And currently, ECG doesn't have the infrastructure to support it. So during the first presentation that I made at ECG, they came around and then they are putting up stuff to support the whole system.
With the water meter, all the infrastructure are available, but we are looking at how we can get a miniature version. But then they are not.
Are you saying we have digital meters?
No, 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 no. But we are thinking of with what I did. I converted the analog meter, and I converted to digital.
Okay, yeah. Including the chip.
And the microcontroller. Yeah, they all.
Okay, so are they going to be like embedded?
Yeah, they will be embedded into the meter.
The challenge is making the microphone of the miniature version.
Yeah.
Version of the whole board that you saw.
Oh, the miniaturization.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I happened to talk to the head of department. You were saying that sometimes even the particular micro transistors and the board that they need, they don't even sell some in Ghana. Nobody, MapLink, which imports such transistors, don't even sell some. So you have to order some. One of them, one student's father bought it for him from the U.S. As soon as the student finished his dissertation, he also finished his product. It costs about $300, and when we are going to ask, I think the budget that is given to them is around $100. So, like what you said, if they don't combine, you can't even buy the board together. And now the department has ordered one board from Germany to serve the whole department, and they are, all these four students were using that board. So you understand, before the innovation can go out, sometimes I think incubators are needed in the institutions. Not just incubators that are supported once, but consistent support with monitoring and evaluation. Okay. So where else, Ghana? Are you also, do you also need consistent?
Who do it, Jacob? Hello, good afternoon. My name is Kofi Okusau. I represent Warehouse Ghana Group. I'm also a student of the University of Ghana Business School, final year studying insurance. I'll be talking to you today about the internet, social media, and fashion. So I'll just give you a brief overview of what Warehouse Ghana is. From the name, I think that maybe you're into warehousing or something of that sort. We are an online trading company, basically. That's what we do. We've got four divisions. The first one is BG, so that's our men's shop. We sell almost everything men from head to toe. Then there's Ladies Pride, our ladies shop. We've got handbags, shoes, dresses, customized stuff. We've got Plastor, our jewelry shop as well. Right now, we do mostly beads, but then we are working on getting gold and silver jewelry for those who are interested as well. And then we've got Roots. Roots is our African art and craft shop. We sell paintings, carvings, and what have you. There's this carving here, which is a Sankofa bed. Would anyone tell us what Sankofa means? It's an expression in tree. For those who don't understand, can anyone tell us what this bed represents? Anybody? Okay, Doc.
I said going back.
Going back. Okay, so I'll leave you at that if nobody wants to comment on it. Then, and then we also do customized furniture and a whole lot of things. These are customized candle holders and photo frames, all in iron and galvanized stuff. And then those are photo holders as well. And then our furniture are all very, very green. We use renewable wood. And then I suppose that this talk should be a very refreshing one for the non-IT people here, because I'm not an IT specialist and I'm not going into the details of the front end and back end of my system and all the tweaks and the tweets and the tweeters and all the tweak aspects of it. Next. Okay, so then we are in a fast changing world. Jack Welch just quoted to have said that the world is changing so fast that if you are not confused, then there must be something wrong with you. So I'll start with water. About a century ago, it would have been very wicked and cruel to say that you are selling water. Somebody comes to your house and you're like, oh, we are selling the water. The person will say, what is this? That's so wicked and cruel. So it moved on from people not selling water to people carrying water in coolers on their heads, going around. And then if you're interested, maybe the person asked about 4 cups or something. So then if you're interested, you call the person drops the cooler, then you fetch, and then you drink. As well as the person wipes the cup with a dirty napkin or something, gives it to the next person drinks. And then it moved on to pouring water into rubber bags. And then it was filtered with a piece of foam. And in Akan, it's called pinyin de pinyin. From there, it moved on to sachet water. And then bottled water. Even beyond bottled water companies realized that people have started refilling their bottles and then using super glue to stick it. So then it felt, so you think it's the real thing. But then when you try opening it, it's so difficult. And people are wondering, what's up? And then when you taste the water, you realize it's different. This isn't the water I know. So then they decided to put these seals around it to protect it. And then what next? We could be looking at vitamin water and so much more. I'll talk about computers as well. 10 years ago, a laptop was like so hot. If you had a laptop, like, hey, you're a guy. But then right now, let me just find out from 3 people. And then in the next about 8 minutes or so, I'd like this discussion to be very interactive. And I do not have much time, so if you ask a question and you have an answer for me, please give it up and let's move on. So I'll just ask people, I'll ask from the IT people here, what's your dream gadget? Let's say Dr. Barton is willing to give you any gadget you want, as of now. What's your dream app electronic gadget?
iPad.
Samsung
Galaxy. iPhone 5. Thank you. So you see, computers have evolved. Right now, if you don't have a tab or one of those things, then you aren't in. And then about seminars. Some time back, would have been a chalk and talk thing. There'll be a big blackboard here with chalk, and then our talk, I'll try and do a couple of diagrams, clean it. By the time the man sitting in front here would be all white with chalk dust. Then move to whiteboard markers. Now we have seminars with projectors. Maybe next year we could have ADW as a webinar. Who knows? So then, this discussion is based on 2 key assumptions. The first one I know is undisputable. Everyone in this room knows something about the internet. The reason why I say that is that if you've never heard about the internet, I just mentioned the word internet, so now you know something about it. And then I'm supposed to be talking about the internet, social media, and passion. So the internet is taken care of, so that's down. Now you're left with social media and passion. So then I'll go to passion. So I'll quote Mark Twain, who said, one interesting thing about work is that you get paid for doing the things you love to do. So then, I assume that those of you here practicing IT and the journalists and all of those here do those jobs, not because of the money you think you can earn, but because you are interested in it. So then, your job is linked to your passion. So that's 2 down. Okay, left to social media. Okay, so Facebook. Facebook needs no introduction to the people in here. Everybody knows Facebook. Then there's the profile for human beings. Then there's the page for social entities, corporations, clubs, what have you. There are the posts, pictures, comments, messages, tags, walls. Some people say that it could be addictive, as you saw the pill over there. And then the more reason why I'm not even going to talk about Facebook is that everybody knows Facebook. This I picked from time.com, Wednesday, July 8, 2009. And then it talked about the moral dilemma a young teen or an adult goes through when you receive a friend request from your parents on Facebook. To accept them as friends or not to. To give them the limited profile or to allow them to see everything that should go online. It's a big thing. So then that's Facebook down. Now Twitter. Lots of people know Twitter, so I'm not going to spend too much time on what Twitter is like all about it. But then one of the key characteristics is the 140 characters per tweet, and then there are multiple tweets all the time. And then something about these social media is that they've revolutionized the way people do a lot of things. I just gave you one very simple practical example. When I came to first year, when I'm in fourth year, I mentioned fourth year, when I came to first year in Lagos, when the guys stand on their balcony or something and ladies are passing by, when they do cat calls, they'll be like, hello, hi, are you looking for me? That kind of thing. And then just that semester, I was pleasantly surprised to hear something new. Two ladies were passing by, and then these guys were on about the third floor of the Care for Next Week, which is a hostel. And then these ladies were passing by. Instead of being the usual sweetheart and the rest, what I heard was, hey, what's your Facebook name? And I was shocked. And the other guy was like, sweetheart, are you on Twitter? I was like, hey. And those are now the kind of cat calls that people are making. I'm like, really, really, there have been changes. So then you might say, my business has both a Facebook and Twitter account, yet I'm not seeing the kind of benefits which I expect to see. How many people here belong to organizations, social clubs, etc., which have either a Facebook account or a Twitter account? How many people? Not too many people. Okay, that's fine. So then I'll just move on. So I'll just give 5 tips on trying to maximize the use of these things for your businesses and all of that. Then there's a caveat here. If you use social media for your businesses to promote them and all of that, you need to be extra, extra careful. Because sometimes people make certain mistakes, they put up tweets which they shouldn't put up, especially the sportsmen overseas and the rest, and it costs them a lot. And then there was also this US senator who was sending a picture as a DM, a direct message to his mistress, and unfortunately he put it up for his over 1,000+ followers, and then that became a big thing. So the first thing is that offer free services online. Whoa, just relax. I don't mean give out your products free of charge, but then I mean give people who follow you on Twitter, give people who visit your Facebook page value for money. For example, if you have a garage, why don't you put up tips on maintaining your cars online, on tips on what people should do to avoid their cars getting broken down frequently, tips on things to do when your car doesn't start and all of that. So people visit this and they can actually benefit from you. You don't just put up your Facebook page and then say repairer of all German vehicles and automatic and blah blah. People already know that they want something, they want to benefit from you. So if you give them some sort of benefits, I'm not saying give out your services free. I sell clothes, act like in a whole lot. I've never yet given out any free online. What I mean is that give them value for the money. Give them a reason to visit your website. Then give them advice. If you do clothes, then give them advice on how to keep your fabric fresh all the time so that the fabric doesn't get faded early. People will come there and come and read about it. The next thing is our promotions and discounts. Everybody loves free. For example, your customer is scrolling through your Facebook page and then sees free or 50% discount. The person does a double take. Whoa, what did you say? Free? 50% discount off. That's one of the things warehouse is thinking of doing. What we'll do is that when our Twitter page is up, we'll tweet discount vouchers. And the first person to use the discount voucher on our website gets the discount. So let's say 50%, 70%, 99%. So if you can get something like that on our Twitter page, then you would follow us expecting to get something back. And then that's reasonable. I gain, you gain. The third thing is make your page attractive and appealing. That's like pretty basic. But then if you want people to come and look at your Facebook page, there should be a reason. There should be some sort of eye candy, something which people would love to look at and look at again. For a clothing company like us, that isn't too difficult, getting a couple of models and all of that. But then if you sell iron rods or construction products, you might be a little handicapped there. The next thing is to update your account regularly. Lots of people do not check their emails frequently. If you want to have an organizational Facebook or Twitter page, you can't do it like you do your email check once in a week or something. You need to go online quite frequently. For Twitter, even updating or posting tweets maybe twice a day might be just too slow. You need to do a lot more of that. And then for Facebook, you need to check on the comments on your wall, reply to them, check your messages, all of that. You need to do that more frequently. If you have a Facebook page and then I write a comment about some service or product which I do not like, and then it takes you about 14 days to reply to the comment. Next time, then you can look at your page. And then the last thing is provide good quality services. You can do all the four, but then if you do not provide good quality services, the people who come the first time, they look at it, they're like, no, this service is bad. In spite of the free offers you provide, the 99% discounts, attractive page, regular updates of your status is responding to comments. If your service is bad, nobody comes. And then beyond listening to this, smiling, making notes, I'd like you to do something about this. Today, this is relevant. Tomorrow, who knows? It could be history. Does anybody remember High Five?
Yeah.
Does anybody remember High Five? It's a social media which used to be hot about 7 years ago. Right now, nobody visits that page. If you told me you looked for me on High Five and didn't find me, I'll just smile at you. And then there's a new kid on the blog, which is coming up pretty, pretty fast. WhatsApp. 2 weeks ago in the news, I read that WhatsApp is now available for Java S40 phones. Would one of the IT kids here tell me what that means? I said, no, I don't mean explaining what Java S40 is, but then I mean, what does it mean to a businessman? What does it mean to a telecommunication company? WhatsApp is now available for Java S40 phones. Would anybody give it a shot? Okay.
When WhatsApp came, first was limited to iPhones and Android phones. Now, as it's available on S60 phones, that means it has a wider market now. A larger number of people can now use the application. It's no more limited to people with iPhones or Android phones.
Thank you very much. That was S60. That was some time back. Now it's S40, just 2 weeks ago. That means a wider market is going on WhatsApp. That means people will be sending less text messages. So that means telecommunication companies will have to find new means of generating money from what they will lose through the lost text messages. So then, even though there's a lot of opportunities, there are threats as well. So it depends on where you sit and the industry which you are in. That'll determine what you do. And then, in preparing this, I got to this point, and I'm like, do I really want to do this? With all the PhDs and IT gurus, do I want to stand here and tell you about IT? Well, I'm a little afraid about this, so then I'll just skip it. So thank you. Thank you very much for your attention. Remember to check out the URL, www.warehousegh.biz. Thank you.